Hey guys, my name is Dylan and this channel is geared towards helping you improve your craft in filmmaking and editing. And today I'm going to show you a fairly hidden and unknown feature in Final Cut Pro that'll help you to create more professional looking color grades. Before I knew this feature, I'd be color grading and always question if I was going past 100, thus blowing out my highlights, or going below 0 and crushing my blacks. It was tough to tell just by looking at the Luma waveform. Check this out though. If we go to View, head down to Range Check, and turn on Luma, now we get zebras that pop up, letting us know if we're losing detail by going past those 0 and 100 IRE markers on our waveform. This feature can save us from cutting out detail in our shots when we grade, and because they instantly let you know when you've gone too far, they'll help you to grade and edit faster. So let's take this example. Turn your range check on by clicking View and going down to Luma Range Check, and we can see that I'm going past both of those points, and I've now lost detail in those areas. So we can just make these adjustments in our color wheels till those zebras are gone. But don't click off yet, there is another thing that this tool can do to help you out. Let's say I want to stylize my grade. I'll pull some cyan into the shadows and push some orange into my highlights. And for this example, I'll really crank the orange here. If we look at the Luma waveform, it shows that we're good. We're not going above 100 and below 0 and there's no zebras. But if we switch the range check to saturation, now zebras are popping up, letting us know that the very brightest highlights here are overly saturated. But thanks to the zebras, now we know. So I'll open up a hue versus sat curve correction, go down to Luma versus sat, and all this tool does is allow us to adjust the saturation of different brightness values. So this will allow us to take out the saturation in this bright area here. I'll click the dropper, select this Luma value, which should show up to the very far right of the line since it's really bright, and I'll start to lower the saturation by dragging down on this line, basically just making a gradual ramp down. Now you'll notice that those zebras disappear. And look at this difference. Let me turn off the range check first. You see how that minor change just makes things look a little bit more realistic with this glare? This is a problem I see a lot in color grades, and this tool really helps you because we're often too blind to see that there's an issue in the first place. Here's a better example for you. Let's say we already graded this clip. We forgot to turn on range check, but if we do now, we can see that these lights are unnatural and have been pushed too far. And that's true, these lights here should be closer to white. So check out the difference the Luma versus sat curve adjustment makes. Boom! It is actually surprising that this isn't so blatantly obvious before. That's why having one of these or both of them up at the same time can be so beneficial when you color grade. If I taught you something today, do me a huge favor and press the thumbs up button and leave a comment below. Subscribe if you want to learn more about Final Cut Pro and filmmaking tips to help you to create better videos, and I will see you in the next one.